Today I decided I wanted to do a big canvas. It's 60 by 80 centimeters. And I wanted to do a flip cup, but I am going to use a bucket. There was once candy in this. I think it's about a 2-liter bucket. So I'm going to fill this with all my colors and then trying to turn the canvas and the bucket. So I hope that will go okay. But I figured this is a nice challenge, and I'm also challenging you to participate and do the same. I think it will be great if we can see different people trying to do the same, and maybe you dare more than me and you even can do it with a bigger bucket. I think it's fun. It will be just for fun, of course. I have a couple of colors and black and white. I will mix the colors with some Dimetico. Of course, I have to get my Dimetico. If I can find it. Where is it? I found it. I have metallic silver. And we are going to use a lot of paint. I have the Prussian blue from Lucas. I have a turquoise also from Lucas. I have a dark blue from Phoenix. And I have a brilliant green from Van Bleiswijk. And black and white, but I won't be doing the Dimeticone in the black and white. I think I'm going to use about 7 drops in each cup. And then stir it very well. So I really hope you guys are going to participate, because I think it's really fun. I think the only trouble is trying to turn the canvas around and the bucket not sink through the canvas, but we'll see. I'll do a little bit more Dimeticone in my silver metallic. Okay, first I will start with filling the bucket with white. Yes, we're going to use really a lot of paint, but that's okay. Then I will use the turquoise. Dark blue, brilliant green, silver metallic, a little bit of black. Metallic again, Prussian blue, brilliant green. A dark blue. The white again. I hope the silicone will work because of course it's not really very much at this amount of paint, so I will put a couple of drops of Dimeticone on top. The turquoise. The Prussian blue. Some more white. Dark blue. The brilliant green. And the metallic silver. Just put this all the sides. I taped some garbage bags. Here's some more metallic silver, by the way. I taped my table with garbage bags to protect my table. This canvas is too big to put it on my tray. And just a little bit more brilliant green. I hope I didn't make a mistake with this amount of paint, but we'll see. I have still have white here, so I can use that if I need it. I will just stir this a little bit. The colors are really beautiful. I will make a close-up for you guys. I really love this color palette. Okay guys, now of course I have to turn the canvas, so I will put the bucket aside. I have to... yes, I'm going to put that down. Then put my canvas on it. Okay, I hope I can do this. This won't be easy. Wow, it worked. I didn't expect it. Okay. Now I will put some white on the sides just to help it flow better. Here's my palette knife so I can divide it just a little bit. Sorry. Okay, guys, well, here we go. Let me see. I will get you a close-up because this is so beautiful. Wow. Okay, now we're trying to tilt the canvas.
Okay,
here we go. Oh no. First, I will use my torch. This looks so beautiful. I wish you guys were here with me so you could see it. There are some air bubbles in it, but not too much. That's because I always pre-mix my paints, so these paints were there for a couple of weeks already. So most of the air is out already. Okay, now I will tilt it first and then torch a little bit more later. Wow, I could jump of joy. It's so beautiful. I will tilt it. Try to be very careful. It feels heavy. I really love this. I wish I could do this every day. It's taking a lot of paint, so I would be finished with my paints really fast. But how beautiful is this, guys? Wow. I hope I won't ruin all the cells. Because of the tilting. This is really amazing. Oh my god, I'm so happy I did this. I was thinking about this for weeks, but I was a little bit scared too. This is so amazing. I'm sorry. I think I will leave the corners white. Okay, I have to wipe my hands, guys. Just put a little bit more white here. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. I really hope you will join me doing this. Although it costs a lot of paint, you get a lot of beauty in return. course, I'll give you a close-up after I'm finished blowing with the torch. Okay, to wipe my hands again. Well, the Dimeticone is working. Lots of cell action here. What an amazing big cells. I think the metallics are really a must in this, because although I put in the silver metallics, it's also giving my other colors, like the brilliant green and all the blues, a metallic shine. I think there's just a thin layer of the silver metallics covering all the paint. Because there's a lot of cell action, I won't blow on all the paint, because I like the cells, but it should not be everywhere. I mean those little ones. So I will skip a couple of pieces, and I'll just blow towards a couple. Yes, this is so great. I'm sorry I'm cheering here, but I'm really happy. Yes, and I really would recommend these colors. They really look beautiful together. There could have been some purple in it, but not more. Okay. Now I'm going to make some close-up for you. Thank you for watching. I hope you will participate in the challenge, because I really would like to see how you would handle a full bucket, and maybe even a bigger bucket on a bigger canvas. I can't wait to see. So I will put it on Facebook, and I will give a hashtag, and the hashtag will say acrylic pouring bucket challenge. So if you are putting your work on Facebook, also put the hashtag acrylic pouring bucket challenge, so I can check every day to see if you did it. And I'm a member of all the acrylic pouring groups, so I probably will see them come by. You also can, of course, let me know on my own Facebook page. That's Saskia. No, it's acrylic. What's my name? Saskia Smith acrylic art, yes. Saskia Smith acrylic art, that's my page. And we also have a group, and that's acrylic pouring Nederland. And all you guys, it doesn't matter what country you are from, are welcome there. Okay, I will make the close-ups for you now. See you later, bye-bye, thank you for watching. I'm trying to get the focus as good as possible, but I'm not so good with all that devices. Do you see how pretty this is? It's so amazing. Oh my God. And you see there are some nice big cells. And where I use the torch, there are some smaller cells. Aren't they pretty? This is so gorgeous. I hope you can see the colors right. I will get you a little bit closer. I really love the Prussian and dark blue coming through. I know people usually don't like the darker colors, but I think they are necessary, yeah, to give your painting some outlines. Look how beautiful. This is so amazing, guys. I'm so happy I did this. I don't know why I was so scared to do it, because it's really fun. Okay, I will give you an overall view, trying to get the focus. I hope you can see, because now I'm filming above my head. Okay, guys, thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye bye. Oh, I will make some pictures, of course.